Hey there, Dr. Cory Workman with Community Hearing Center here in Estes Park, Colorado. Today's video is going to be a simple one. We're just going to take you through the anatomy of a hearing aid. So first style of hearing aid I'd like to talk with you about here is a receiver in the ear or receiver in the canal, or you might hear it referred to as a RIC or a RITE. So this is a pretty common style of hearing aid that you see on the market. And let's start on the back of the hearing aid. Behind, in most of these, you have a program button right back here that can be used to set various settings with the hearing aids, including volume control and program changes. On the bottom of the hearing aid is the battery door. Most have a little notch here that you can grab and pull open, and you'll see that there's your battery right there. The battery in most of these hearing aids only goes in one direction. You always want to make sure that the hearing aid battery is placed in the hearing aid correctly. So that is where your hearing aid battery goes. You close the battery door and go around to the top. Microphones on most of these receiver in the ear or receiver in the canal hearing aids are here at the top. There's one here at the top and there's one here at the back. In this particular style of hearing aid, the microphones are covered by a protective cover, and if we were to take that protective cover off like so, you would see underneath that there's the microphone ports there. So as we come around to the front, these are probably the parts that you would be most commonly working with, and let's take a look at those now. All right, as we come around the front of the hearing aid, this is the receiver wire here running across the top. And the receiver or the speaker that delivers sound to the ear is this part right here, the gray box that has the writing on it. This piece hanging out of the front is called a sport lock or retention wire. This helps to hold everything in place in your ear in the proper position. Now the two most common parts that you'll interact with your receiver in the canal or receiver in the ear hearing aid is the dome, this black piece here on the end, and underneath the dome, if you squeeze and pull, is what we call a wax guard. Now the wax guard is the number one reason why we get a phone call usually about my hearing aid's not working, and that gets plugged up with earwax at times. And in another video, I'm going to show you how to change that and keep it clean. So again, let's review the parts of the hearing aid one more time. This white piece here is called the wax guard. The rubber tip that goes on the end can be called a tip or a dome, and they come in various shapes and sizes. The gray box here on the end is called the receiver with the wire that goes back to the hearing aid body itself. On the back, you have your program button, and on the bottom is your battery door. That is the anatomy of a receiver in the ear or receiver in the canal hearing aid. Next, let's move to a custom hearing aid and look at the parts on that one. All right, next we're going to move to what we would call an in-the-ear. This is a larger size, an in-the-ear hearing aid. You can also get them smaller that you may hear them called a completely in the canal, a CIC or an ITC in the canal. This style of hearing aid has the battery door on the outside here that opens that way. Your microphone port, where the microphone lives, is here at the front. And if we turn the hearing aid over, you'll see again, there's that wax guard, and the receiver or the speaker unit is inside the hearing aid here. Some of these styles of hearing aids have an additional hole here, and what that is called is a vent. We use that vent to help with comfort with the hearing aid, but also to change the acoustic or sound response of the hearing aid. So on this style of hearing aid, again, your parts are the battery door is here, microphones are usually here on the front face. This is called the face plate here on the front face of it. And then we have the receiver with the wax guard here, and you also may have the vent tube here. On the end of some of these custom hearing aids, you may see a rubber tube extending out of it. That's called a tube extender, and that's used again to help with some of the acoustics or the way that the hearing aid fits in the person's ear. So that's the anatomy of the custom hearing aid. Thanks for joining us on our video today about the anatomy of hearing aids. Stay tuned to our YouTube channel as our next series of videos will be about cleaning and care of the hearing aids. Now that we know the parts, we can talk to you about how to clean and care for the hearing aids on your own. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with those around you, and we'll see you next time.